وَنَحْشُرُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ زُرْقًا. And those mujrimeen, those people who happen to be criminals, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise them up on that day, zurqa, blue-eyed. Okay? Now, some of the deviant sects, such as the Nation of Islam, they believe that this is referring to white people. Okay? Because the word zurqa, the mufassirin, they explained it to be blue-eyed. And I remember several years ago that I was standing in the heart of downtown Toronto, and I met someone from the Nation of Islam, and they started speaking to me, and they obviously saw that I'm a Muslim, and they are also, they affiliate to Islam as well. So they started speaking to me, and in the conversation, they, of course, I said, why do you think that the white people are devils, and so on and so forth, because that's the premise on which the entire Nation of Islam was founded. It's not an Islamic movement, they just call themselves the Nation of Islam, right? So, and of course, it's very sidelined, and it's very, very new as well, just was founded in the last century. Malcolm X was one of the great preachers of this, but then he moved out to regular Islam, basically the Islam of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all of the generations thereafter. So he said, he quoted this verse. He said, وَنَحْشُرُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ زُرْقًا. And of course, this movement didn't come out of a void. It came out of the extreme racism which black people in the United States of America had to deal with throughout the 20th century. And also till today, to some degree, black people in the United States and many other parts of the world continue to face racism. Now, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam came and he eradicated this racism from the face of the Arabian Peninsula. Anyone who treated anyone with racism, he would be very, very harshly brought to justice. And the law would deal with him very, very severely from the very get-go of Islam. And that's why anyone, from amongst the closest of companions of the Prophet ﷺ that would make a racial comment, the Prophet ﷺ wouldn't take this lightly. He would take it very seriously so that this particular idea of racism becomes eradicated. But because, as I said, the 20th century was a very racially supercharged time, and to be honest, now we are going through another similar era of a very racially supercharged time as well, more against Muslims than it was than other people. Just as yesterday it used to be more against black people than towards other people as well. But that is not to undermine the racism that black people till today experience. It is disgusting, it is despicable, it shouldn't be tolerated in the least. But on the flip end, we cannot become extreme on the other end as well, and then start misquoting the verses of the Quran and say, look, the mujrimeen, the criminals, Allah said they will be raised on the day of judgment blue-eyed, zurqa. Okay, so that means who has blue eyes? White people have blue eyes, as in they're the mujrimeen. They must be the criminal. This is what this individual was telling me in the heart of downtown Toronto. But anyways, I told them that, let me ask you a question. What does the word zurq mean? The word zurq means blue, okay? It means, it's the plural of az-zarqa. Or it's the plural of, it's the plural of the singular word blue, okay? So how do you know for sure that the zurq are in fact the uyun? How do you know for sure that the blueness is in fact within the eyes? Because even the mufassirin have differed about this, whether it's referring to blue eyes. And when they say blue eyes, they further explain that not just blue eyes for the sake of blue eyes, because human beings have blue, black, brown, and other complexions in eyes as well. So it's not referring to blue eyes that a person is born with. It is referring to the blueness that gets in the eye when a person goes blind. Okay? That's the blueness that this is referring to. Or when a person has the lack of... Or the person is dehydrated. Dehydration can also lead to slight blueness within the eyes. So that is the blueness that this must be referring to. It's not referring to the natural blue eyes that people end up having. That cannot be the case. That's if the word zurq is referring to eyes, right? And as I said, I asked him, how do you know? So naturally his response was that the person who had explained this, he has 20 years of experience in Arabic. What experience do you have? Anyways, that's not a comment that's of any use. It's not a comment that should be responded to. The word zurq simply means blue. There's nothing about the eyes in the ayah of the Quran itself. So that's why the scholars of tafsir differed. Whether the blueness is in the eyes or the blueness is in the body itself. You know how when somebody gets punched in the face, may Allah protect you and I, the eyes go blue, right? So that's a blue eye, right? And similarly, if a person gets harmed anywhere in the body, on the arms, on the bruises, right? They're all blue. So some mufassirin, they said that this is referring to bruises all over the body. So the blueness that occurs because of the bruises all over the body, because they'll be coming out, resurrected through out of the graves. So it's and of course the graves are within the ground, so when they're coming out, it could be that they get bruised along the way, and for any other purpose. Anyways, Allah tells us only the fact that they will be resurrected zurqan, right, blue. As for the eyes or the or whether it's the skin or the body, or if even if it is the eyes, as many mufassirin did say, then it is definitely not the natural blue that people have that happen to be Caucasian. It's referring to the blue that happens when a person becomes blind.